Okay, guys, we are going to try this again. And I'm going to try not to cry like a little emotional ass pussy. I'm sorry. I don't know why I cried in the last one. It was just, I don't know, man. It was real, bro.
No,
it
this
just,
is,
I don't know. I'm going to try not to cry this time,
though.
No.
Oh, points God. In my life and,
I'm watching this video
this
last,
is
by the way.
To be. I said I won't get emotional,
because I might cry.
I just love it here, you know.
But I'm trying not to.
People just embrace me and just feels like home, man. And Phillip Serena staff, my guys were there, Coach Ham, everybody. So just made sense, you know, like I'll walk away from something so perfect, and having Wes bring me back, man, it's just, you know, it's not often in this league where you can say you want something to happen and it happens. So when you get to come back, it's just that much more special, and I thank y'all for just embracing.
All right, Basemore, be smooth, bro. You fell asleep in the middle of the game, bro.
Just thank you for giving me a chance. Thank you for
believing. Oh, shit, this is pretty new.
This is a real new beginning for me, and I'm happy to share that, you know, with my loved ones.
Oh, this is pretty new. If they got Dwight Howard in the Hall of Fame.
I'm standing here, and he's not. And we all know why. It's not Tim Duncan to bring any attention to himself. So I figured I better come out here and do this and somehow say goodbye to him, which is an impossibility for a lot of reasons. But
oh no, y'all really
try to think of how to compare him and what to say about him. And I got a few thoughts that might be boring for all of you, but you know, everybody always talks about who they like to eat dinner with. You know, if you had one night, you could go to dinner, go to lunch with so-and-so, who would you like to do it with? My dinner would be with Timmy. And it would be because he's the most real, consistent, true person I've ever met in my life. He is
Damn.
So genuine that
this
it blows your mind.
Is the way
one would always expect Timmy to go out. You know, he's the same person as far as his values and opinions of himself as the day he came in. I can still remember before his father passed away looking at me in the eye and saying that I'm going to hold you responsible to make sure that when he's done, he's the same person he is now. And in that respect, he is.
That's real as fuck. That's real as fuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my profound honor to present the 2014 Jimmy V Perseverance Award to Stuart Scott.
Bro, y'all are really trying to make me cry. G, y'all finna bring out Stuart Scott and shit. G, rest in peace,
Stuart
Scott.
When I first heard that I was gonna be honored with this reward, the very first thing that I did was I was speechless. Briefly, I've presented this award before. I mean, I've watched in awe as Kay Yao and Eric LeGrand and all these other great people grace this stage. And although intellectually I get it, I'm a public figure. I have a public job. I'm battling cancer. Hopefully, I'm inspiring. At my gut level, I really didn't think that I belonged with those great people. But I listened to what Jim Valvano said 21 years ago. The most poignant 7 words ever uttered in any speech anywhere. Don't give up. Don't ever give up. Those great people didn't. Coach Valvano didn't. So to be honored with this, I now have a responsibility to also not ever give up. I also realized something else recently. You heard me kind of allude to it in the piece. I said, I'm not losing. I'm still here. I'm fighting. I'm not losing. But I got to amend that. When you die, that does not mean that you lose to cancer. You beat cancer by how you live, why you live, and in the manner in which you live. what's going on probably the last 10 days. I just got out of the hospital this past Friday. 7-day stay. Man, I crashed. I had liver complications, I had kidney failure. I had 4 surgeries in a span of 7 days. As of Sunday, I didn't even know if I'd make it here. I couldn't fight.
That's your words, bro.
But doctors and nurses could. The people that I love, my friends and family, they could fight. My girlfriend, who slept on a very uncomfortable hospital cot by my side every night, she could fight. The people that I love did last week what they always do. They visited, they talked to me, they listened to me, they sat silent sometimes. They loved me. And that's another one of the components of the V Foundation. This whole fight, this journey thing is not a solo venture. This is something that requires support. I called my big sister Susan a few days ago. Why? I needed to cry. It was that simple. And I know that I can call her, I can call my other sister Cynthia, my brother Stephen, my mom and dad, and I can just cry. And those things are very important. I have one more necessity, and it's really two. Two very vibrant, intelligent, beautiful young ladies. The best thing I've ever done, the best thing I will ever do, is be a dad to Taylor and Sydney. It's true. I can't ever give up because I can't leave my daughters. But Taylor and Sydney, I love you guys more than I will ever be able to express. You two are my heartbeat. I am standing on this stage here tonight because of you.
Dude, what the fuck, bro?
I want to say thank you, ESPN. Thank you, ESPYs. Thank all of you. Have a great rest of your night and have a great rest of your life.
Fuck the hell. Rest in peace to this guy, bro.
Tony Parker really got aggressive there in the third quarter. And, you know, they keep running a lot of guys in. And once they got away from us, we, you know, we keep battling as much as we could. We turned the ball over too much tonight and made some threes late, but the three-pointers and were kind of a difference there for us. And it's a tough battle. But as far as, you know, this game, this series, and this season, I hope you guys all took notice of what happened in the last 3 minutes of the game because, you know, Matt and Vince, they wanted to finish the game. And I think that's what Grizzlies basketball is about. Those guys are pros. And for what we've been through, I'd do anything for those guys. They've embraced every guy who came in, no matter what their history was. They cared about them. They tried to have them. These guys fought. And I can't tell you enough how proud I am of every guy that is in that locker room and has come through that locker room. This season's been hard. It's been really hard. And I could have quit. Could have not made the playoffs. And every day they came out and they fought like crazy. This was not planned. So I hope as a community, and I know we do, we love our Grizzlies. We love on those guys. And wish them the best as they go forward in their career and hopefully, you know, a long time with us. And that's all I got today. Thank you for a great season.
Alan Elliott, ShorePartsNJ.com. Over here.
Oh, sorry. Shit.
Besides coaches, are there any teammates that helped you along the way that helped you get to where you are today?
Aaron McKee.
Oh, shit.
Aaron McKee. I mean,
he can't even say anything. Damn.
I mean, he was my teammate. But it was on another level. You know, I mean, he was my teammate, he was my friend. And helped me with a lot of personal issues that I had, you know, things that were going on in my life. It was different from just being a teammate. You know what I mean? Like, I love a lot of the guys that I played with, always gonna love them. You know, I'm always gonna feel that way, you know, a certain way about Eric Snow and Theo Radcliffe. It's always gonna be that feeling. It's always gonna be that relationship. You know, it's never gonna go anywhere. But Aaron McKee was just like a different teammate that I had. You know, it was more than just basketball when it came to me and him.
If they would have showed that after Stuart Scott, I probably would have been in tears by now. Oh shit, not Kobe.
Man! Guys, you know, I can't believe how fast 20 years went by. I mean, this is crazy. This is absolutely crazy. And, you know, to be standing here at center court with you guys, my teammates behind me, and appreciating all this, you know, the journey that we've been on. You know, we've been through our ups and been through our downs. And I think the most important part is that we all stayed together throughout. You know, I grew up a diehard, I mean a diehard Laker fan. Diehard. I mean, I knew everything about every player that's ever played here. So to be drafted and then traded to this organization and to spend 20 years here, I mean, you can't write something better than this. And I'm more proud of the fact that not about the championships, but about the down years, because we didn't run. We played through all that stuff. We got our championships.
Hey, fuck cancer, bro.
We did it the right way.
For real.
And all I can do here is just thank you guys. Thank you guys for all the years of support. Thank you guys for all the motivation. Thank you for all the inspiration. I can't believe it's come to an end. You guys will always be in my heart, and I sincerely, sincerely appreciate it. No words can describe how I feel about you guys, and thank you from the bottom of my heart. God, I love you guys, and I love you guys, and to my family, my wife Vanessa, our daughters Natalia and Gianna, you know, thank you guys for all your sacrifice. You know, for all the hours I spent in the gym working and training, Vanessa, you holding down the family the way that you have. I can't, there's no way that I can thank you enough for that. So, God, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. And, what can I say? Mamba out.
Okay. I didn't cry. Oh man, I almost did, dude. That Stuart Scott, bro. I don't got too much to say, but that Stuart Scott really got to me. That almost made me cry. Dude. I like to feel that shit. Yeah, that shit is really fucking sad. I've never seen that clip before either. Cancer is fucked up, bro. Cancer is what killed my grandpa, who I'm named after. Like, cancer, like, has affected a lot of people I know. Cancer touches almost every single family. I don't know, man, this shit is real. He was saying a lot of real ass shit up there. That was probably my favorite one. You guys let me know your favorite one. Timmy Martin Diaz, Instagram, I'm coming up. All of that cool shit, man. I'm out of here. And if you better go be my name. Man, no more Kobe talk. I talk a lot of shit about Kobe, but Kobe really was my nigga, bro. Like, everybody who makes it to the end of the video, I was a Kobe fan before I was a LeBron fan. Like, for real, that's on everything I love, man.
ground.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my. No.